On the fateful night of December the 2nd and morning of the December the 3rd in 1984, Bhopal witnessed the world's worst industrial disaster. About 40 tons of gas leaked from the Union Carbide factory, which killed over 1,700 people as per government estimates, but activists claim over 8,000 people died. Till date, over 5 lakh people have been affected by it, and now gas victims claim that the tragedy has scarred the coming generations, as well as many children of gas victims who have now been born with abnormalities. Even after 30 years of the tragedy, the gas victims and activists are waiting for closure. Even after 3 decades, the gas survivors continue their fight for a proper rehabilitation package, better healthcare facilities, and action against the officials of the Union Carbide responsible for the disaster.
Taha Qureshi and Unnati Agarwal, both born several decades after the horrific Bhopal gas tragedy. But their parents convinced the toxic fumes they inhaled 30 years ago have scarred the next generation. 2-year-old Taha suffers from blood cancer, and what deepens their suspicion is that his 2 cousins are also not normal.
इसकी तबीयत खराब गैस की वजह से ही हो रही हो, जैसे कि हम दोनों को है तो बच्चे को तो हो सकता है। वो खर्चा पूरा 50 लाख का बताया, अभी तक तो कम से कम 7-1 लाख रुपए खर्चा हो चुके, पता नहीं है,
हैं? पैसे जुटाए कहाँ से?
पैसे क्या जुटाए, हमने अपने जेवरों को गिरवी रख दिया, अपनी दुकान बेच दी।
भारती अग्रवाल वॉज ओनली अ बेबी व्हेन द इंडियाज वर्स्ट इंडस्ट्रियल डिजास्टर शुक भोपाल and was fortunate to not suffered. But Unnati, her second daughter, was born blind and with a stunted brain.
डॉक्टर के पास जब गए थे, सबसे पहले पता लगा इस कंडीशन जब मैं पैदा हुई
जी,
तो डॉक्टर ने क्या बताया?
डॉक्टर ने मुझसे यही पूछा था कि जब गैस निकली थी आप कहाँ पर थी और आप कितनी बड़ी थी, तो मैंने बताया सर भोपाल में थी और करीबन 2-2.5 साल की मेरी उम्र थी।
तो उन्होंने कुछ बताया कि कनेक्शन हो सकता है?
हाँ सर, उन्होंने ऐसा ही बोला था।
Activists allege government turned a blind eye to the thousands of second and third generation gas victims, as they are not entitled to free medical assistance. While NGOs claim there is enough research to prove how those born after the disaster were affected, the Madhya Pradesh government still has no definite answers.
सेकेंड जनरेशन विक्टिम्स की पॉसिबिलिटी है जो पानी से कंटामिनेशन हुआ हो, या फिर जो पेरेंट्स जिनके गैस विक्टिम हो उनके बच्चों में कुछ डिफेक्ट या कुछ प्रॉब्लम आई हो?
जी जरूर, उनमें प्रॉब्लम आ रही है और मैं पिछले 10 साल से यहाँ संभावन ट्रस्ट क्लिनिक में काम कर रहा हूँ और मैं रोज देखता हूँ। लगभग आप मान के चलो कि 20 में से 1 बच्चा को मैं बोल सकता हूँ कि कहीं ना कहीं उनको कंजेनिटल डिफेक्ट्स हुआ या किसी तरह मानसिक विकार हुआ या फिर उनमें एनीमिया हुआ, खून की कमी हुआ, स्किन डिसीज हुआ।
एक्चुअली I will say that when we talk about genetic linkage or transmission of effect of MIC or the gas exposure to the first or the second or the third generation, this is something where we lack evidence right now.
Is there a requirement for such studies, you feel?
Definitely. There is one study right now going on which is looking at genetic changes in the siblings of the gas victims.
30 years ago, poisonous gas leaked from this Union Carbide factory in Bhopal. In the last 3 decades, the activists claim things have only worsened on the ground. They say that the second and the third generation of the gas victims too are affected by it. Whereas the government's research is underway, which they say will be able to establish whether it is true or not, but that will only happen by 2016. In Bhopal, with camera person Rizwan Khan, Siddharth Ranjan Das for NDTV.